Welcome back to Caddies. Today we are going to make a ball bearing. So I'll first start with the outer ring. So I'll go to right plane and sketch, and I'll make the profile first. So I'll choose line and give this first as 36.32. Okay. Then I will give a horizontal. Okay, first I'm going to make a center line through the origin and give the distance of this line from the center line as 65. Okay, select. Now go to the midpoint of this line and origin and select relation vertical. Now again choose line. Draw a profile like this. Give a center line to this. Choose these two. Choose mirror and mirror about this center line. Okay. Now choose 3-point arc. Choose these two points and select this. Okay. Now go to smart dimension. Select this arc and give the radius as 12 millimeter. Now give this distance as 53. Okay. Also, now define the distance of this center point of the arc to this line as 8 millimeter. So now our geometry is fully defined. Now I'm going to go to features and revolve. So, axis of revolution, I will choose this line. So now I have this profile. Click OK. Now go to chamfer and choose this angle distance type chamfer and give this distance as 2.1 millimeter and choose this face. Okay, so now my outer ring is ready. I will save this outer ring. Now I will go to a new part. Now I'm going to make the inner ring. I'll go to again right plane. First I will draw a center line and I will draw one more center line. Now I'll choose line. This I will choose, go to mirror and mirror about center line. There are many ways when you can and now I will make this coincident. There are multiple ways which you can define a geometry, so just use whatever is convenient to you. I will give a relation vertical. Now again I'll go to 3-point arc and choose these both and okay. Now I'll go to smart dimension and start defining it. This distance will be 25 millimeter. This distance will be 37 millimeter. Now this width is going to be 31. Okay, and this radius I will keep again 12 millimeter. Now this distance I will keep 8. So again now my geometry is fully defined. I'll go to features and revolve, axis of revolution, this center line. Now I have this. Now here I will choose fillet and 2.1 millimeter fillet again, and I will choose this face. So here you can see this face is, this ring is also ready. Now I will save it as inner ring. Again I'll go to new part. Now I have to make a sphere, so I will just go to front plane and ओके, आई विल चूज सेंटर पॉइंट आर्क एंड गिव रेडियस एज 12. दिस हैज टू बी आर 12. नाउ आई विल चूज दिस टू बी फिल्ड. Okay, now I'll go to features and revolved boss base, revolve about this line. So now my sphere is ready. I will save this part as ball. Now I'll go to a new assembly. Go to new assembly, check this. Select outer ring, inner ring, and ball. Okay. First, I will right click this and click on float. Now, I'll go to mate, select this, and select this, and give a relation concentric. Okay. Now I'll choose this plane and this plane. Okay. Now I'll choose this ball and select this inner side. Flip and give relation as tangent. Okay. Also, I will click this inner circle and click fix. Now I'm going to select this sphere and go to circular component pattern and choose the parameter as here equal spacing. I will enable and choose 7 spheres. Okay, now these are copied with mates. So now if I show you, this inner circle is fixed, so I cannot move it. Now if I move this one, this is actually rotating, but you cannot see because all of those are in the same color. Okay, so now your ball bearing is complete. You can give any appearances to it if you want, any materials. Actually, this is not aligned, so you can give a distance mate if you want. So, but this geometry is complete.